I'm going to have a go at breaking the bead on this. This is the Harbour Freight bead breaker. I've noticed that it doesn't actually open up wide enough to get the tire in. It's too tall. So I've got to lift it up at an angle and start pushing it in from the top here. I've got some of this tire lube in already. What I've got to do now is get that bead off, and it really doesn't want to come. So I'm going to try a few more tricks. Maybe if I move that out of the way. It's going to take some effort. It just needs some extra leverage with this pipe. And I've got the bead broken now. I can work it around and get the rest of the bead off this side. I've got one side done, just starting on side number two. There we go. And all I've got to do is work the rest of the tire off, which I'll do in my little fixture over here. Easy. Pop them back on as I'm doing it. Work my way around. Get the bead off. That gets all the lube in there too. See if I can get it over this rim protector strip. I've never had much luck with them. Oh, this might actually be working. Off one side. Now the thumb bit is getting the other side off. That's a real trick. Oh, should have recorded that. Wow, just got a lever in right here. Put another one in right there. And by the time I got leverage on both, started coming right off, which is a miracle. Never does that normally. Right, so I've got the wheel set up on with the axle in. I put the nut back on the one end. This keeps it fairly level. See, I'll give it a little kick. And the heavy spot on the wheel, because it's a cast wheel, so they all have heavy spots on. Wait for it to slow down, then I'll mark it, then I'll give it a kick in the other direction. Okay, so we'll let this settle at the bottom. Good, we'll put it up here, 90 degrees, see where it settles at the bottom this time. Because there's a bit of friction in the wheel bearings, so they always sit in a slightly different position. Right, let's run about where that spoke is. So now we've got two marks on there, and the heavy spot will be right in between them, and that's going to be close enough for putting the tire on. Right, so I've got it back on the fixture, disc side down. So when I look at the bike, the brake is on the right. Brake's on the right. So the rotation I'm looking at is counterclockwise. I've got the arrow going counterclockwise. So it will go on this way. So I've got this side pushed up. So I've lubed up the tyre. Should be able to just push it on. I need the levers. I hope. Maybe this one's a bit stiff because it's new. bit more lube, I think. All right. Well, that was a lot harder getting that first side on. It's meant to be easy getting the first side on. Should just slide right over, but it didn't. I guess the new tire is a lot stiffer than the old one. Okay. Now it's all dried out, so I've got to lube up the second side of the tire again, including on the inside of the wheel, because I've got to get it over that lip. So the inside's got to be lubed, as well as the outside. Puffed out. It was a rough wrestling match and a half getting that on. But it's on, I've got it the right way round, and got the yellow dot right where it's meant to be. Time to balance it. Got a very small foot pump. It's going to take a long time to put 40 psi in this tire. One side just popped on, heard the distinctive pop. Be over there. Now. There it goes. Yay. Now I know I've got both feet seated. I just continue to pump the rest of the way. You can probably see the tire moving very slowly around. I'll give it a little push. But that is much more in balance than the previous one was. When I put the light with the heavy and stuff, it all kind of works out. So now I'm going to put a 10 gram weight instead of the 20 that was on there, opposite the heavy point where it just stopped right there. Let's see if I can get this wheel back in. I've got a couple of bits of 2x4 down here to put the tire on. I've got the axle ready with the adjuster already on it. So I've done this once before and I forgot. You do have to put the brake caliper holder on along with it, that side. Because you've got to get that slot going up the swinging arm piece as the wheel goes in. So it's all fun juggling. This tire is actually a pretty tight fit. There's not a lot of spare room. I've got those two spacers in. And I'm going to be very careful not to knock them out. Wrapped. All I've got to do is lift it up and get the axle in. There's one wrong with it backwards. That's where you've got to stick your finger in the other side and lift that spacer. Well, no room. The spacer in between the two bearings has dropped down. I'm going to have to move it into position. We'll do the axle torque. One of the clever bits of design here are these spacers. The adjusters are here, so you don't actually have to do the wheel alignment again. Leave the adjusters where they are. You can get the axle in with enough slack and get these adjusters on both sides. All I've got to do now is torque it. So I grab the chain on the left, pull it up as I'm talking, and that will suck in the slack in both sides. It'll pull the wheel forward. I'm getting the torque from like this. There we go. There is a bit of a trick with getting the rear brake on. There's only one sliding pin for the pad. The other side is like a car and it sits on two flats. So you've got to get the pads on and have them sit on that ledge. Then put this 14mm bolt in. And you just grab this and kind of move around until the thread goes in easily. Because it does slide in here. And then you put the final pin in the back. Final bolt. you've got to do it that way around.